Hey, I have something to share with you and it may surprise you. I do have an information I barely can consider as a leak since it's coming from a source that I cannot confirm that it's reliable or not, but I know for sure that this person is in the industry. So let's talk once again about the upcoming Apple event and everything that it's coming with possibly biggest potential surprise ever. Hi friends and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, tech rumors and reviews. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment below, hit the like button and don't forget to enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. Let's deal with basics first. On March 8, according to one of the most reliable names in the industry, Mark Gurman from Bloomberg, Apple will organize their first virtual presentation this year. While leaks and predictions have varied from source to source, it's been anticipated we will see few products which are now considered as almost 100% certain. The iPhone SE with similar design of its predecessor, with a specs bump to A15 Bionic, 5G and possibly some less mentioned internals. The second device that's been frequently part of speculations was the iPad Air 5th gen. Visually similar to the iPad Air from 2020, should arrive with better processor as well, following the footsteps of the iPad Mini 6 with 5G and 12 megapixel ultra-wide front-facing camera as some of the most important upgrades. For rear cameras, we're still not certain, with some predicting even two-shooter setup. Both of these Apple products may keep the same price tag, and that's why they may be worth waiting for. Yet the biggest question mark is related to Macs. Which new Macs will Apple showcase this March? Will it be long-awaited Mac Mini redesign in multiple colors, with more powerful M1 Pro and M1 Max chips, refreshed 24-inch iMacs with the M2 processor, or even its bigger counterpart, non-Pro 27-inch model? It's still a matter of guessing. One of the most recent news that we got is that there will be a new MacBook Pro, bringing all new 2022 chip, but allegedly still sticking to the old 2016 design language. What was that? Unfortunately, tech medias and fruit enthusiasts have fired tons of critics to that news, describing the touch bar as a menace that refuses to die. Very dramatic. Personally, I have nothing against it, especially if it's the entry-level model. But let's be honest, Apple can always bring back the function keys from the 2016 design, so stop your whining. If you don't know my opinion, Apple's biggest mistake was to put the touch bar on the Pro MacBook. That thing was made for mainstream and MacBook Air, but Apple made a mistake. This takes me to the most important subject of this video. One of my contacts gave me an info, which once again can be easily misinterpreted. With that said, I heard that Apple will actually showcase its all-new MacBook Air March. Regardless if we need a bunch of salt with this information, there are a couple of reasons why this could be possible. I mean, if the M2 chip is ready, expected with the new MacBook Pro, there is absolutely no reason why Apple should not introduce the new Air right now in spring. Not to mention we already seen leaked renders. I know that doesn't mean a lot, considering that we saw long ago Mac Mini leaked renders as well, but it could be. This new MacBook Air should allegedly come in colors following the pattern of the 24-inch iMac, likely similar color scheme, including infamous white bezels. Some are saying there will be notch and even mini LED display, but I wouldn't go that far. I would like to be wrong for that. The question is, since some speculations have pointed out how we could see three different Macs, question for you, is it possible that we really see this new MacBook Air on March 8th? Please answer below. And if you were wondering based on my previous videos, I'm secretly wish to see the standard iMac iPad as well, at least based on those leaked product numbers. However, recent information from the same contact made me change my mind, and I will make another video about it, so stay tuned. That's it from me. Make sure you subscribe, hit the thumbs up and turn on notifications. Don't forget to check the links in the description and a pinned comment. You may find some awesome discounts there. Thank you so much for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.